In 2015, so about 3 years ago, I woke up one morning and couldn't walk, literally just couldn't put any pressure on my legs whatsoever. It was a weird week because these amazing things were happening. We had just opened the doors to our brand new church plant, and my first book came out, and so we were like celebrating all these incredible things that God was doing. And at the time, I was a runner, so I thought it was a running injury, and I tried, you know, like rest, ice, compression, elevation, and that didn't work, and was eventually hospitalized and diagnosed with an autoimmune disease. In the middle of that week, the other thing that was going on is that my family received word that we lost my cousin Cameron, really tragically. He was snowshoe hiking in Crater Lake National Park, Oregon, and fell off the side of the cliff, never to be heard from again. And then on top of that, we were tending to the needs of my youngest son, Nolan, who was recovering from spinal cord surgery. And so it was this weird week of celebration, our church plant, my book, you know, things that Kevin and I had been praying about for a long time, we were seeing God bring to fruition, but then this just grief and trauma. And I've been walking with Jesus for over 30 years, and I wish that I could say I, like, you know, rose above and more than conquered and did all the Christian cliches you're supposed to do, but I didn't. I just kind of fell into despair. For me, the only thing that brought me back to a place of hope and a place of really understanding intimacy with God in times of suffering was the spiritual discipline and the biblical language of lament. And so this book kind of started just as my own lament journey, but then as I talked to other people and realized all of us are suffering, all of us have some type of wound, big or small, that all of us want to know that God is in the middle of it, that hope exists on the other side. We all need something to cling to. And so I just felt like I need to write a book about lament to invite followers of Jesus to find him in the middle of, you know, seasons where it feels like he's not even there. And so that's why I wrote the latter song, to bring hope in the middle of deep pain.